Today I'm going to just revise all the points what we have learned in the lesson heat. In short. So first, introduction. Introduction is nothing but in what is meant by the heat? Heat is nothing but it is a form of energy. Yes or no? So if you will see the SI unit, that is this international unit or standard unit, accepted unit of the heat is joule or calorie. Are you getting this? If you want to convert 1 joule joule into calorie, then there is one formula, that is one joule is nothing but 4.184 calorie. 1 joule is nothing but 4.184 calories. Are you getting? So this is about the introduction. Then after the introduction we have learned the concept of temperature. What is meant by the temperature? Temperature is nothing but a degree of hotness and coldness is known as a temperature. The sensation to have the hotness or the coldness is called as a temperature. Then the standard unit of temperature is Kelvin. We can measure the temperature or the system or the standard unit or the accepted unit by the team is the Kelvin. The unit of the temperature is Kelvin. Actually, the temperature can be measured in it has a three different scales, that is Celsius, Fahrenheit and Kelvin scale, that we have seen in the last videos. Then there are two types of thermometer. To measure the temperature, we need an instrument. To measure the temperature, we need an instrument that is called as a thermometer. Now, for the heat also, if you want to measure the heat, the instrument used, calorimeter, the instrument used to measure the heat is calorimeter. Are you getting? Then to measure the temperature, we need an instrument that is called as a thermometer. Now, there are the mainly two types of thermometer, laboratory, clinical, and one more type of the thermometer is there, that is maximum minimum thermometer, which is used to measure or to get the record of the weather. To get a weather condition, we use the maximum minimum thermometer. But mostly we are going to study these two types of thermometer, that is laboratory thermometer and clinical thermometer. Laboratory thermometer is used to get the temperature of the chemicals. We use this thermometer, laboratory thermometer. The range of laboratory thermometer is from minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. Very important thing is that the range of this is minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. So this is the range of the laboratory thermometer. Then the next thermometer is clinical thermometer. It is also called as a doctor's thermometer. Clinical thermometer is also called as a doctor thermometer. Now if you will see the clinical thermometer, it has a small bending. In a thermometer, it has a very small bending that is called as a key, which can hold the mercury level. This is a very important thing, or we can see the difference between the laboratory and clinical thermometer, that clinical thermometer has a key which can hold the mercury level. Are you getting? Then so the level of the, as soon as when we remove from our mouth, the level does not comes immediately down. We get a, for to get an accurate reading, if you will, it has a key which helps to keep the reading at a particular temperature. Then the next point is we have learned about the transfer of heat. For this I have given the example. If the teachers want to distribute the notebook, the teacher can distribute either in the three ways. Okay. First is means I can go to give directly the notebooks to the particular student, or second thing is I can call the particular child to my place and I will give the particular name, I will hand over the notebooks to the child. Third thing, I will directly throw the notebook to the particular child. So these are the three ways I can distribute the notebook. In this, it is just example to explain the concept of transfer of heat. Means transfer of heat takes place in these three types: conduction, convection, and radiation. Now conduction. Conduction is what? I will distribute the notebook while going to the particular place. Now if the child is sitting on the first bench, I will go to that place and I will distribute his notebook. If the child is sitting on the last bench, then I will go to that place and I will give the notebook. That is the process of conduction. What actually the things happens here? The heat transfer from hotter object to the colder object. For example, now if you will take a pan, if you are cooking and if you will keep the spoon in the metal spoon in that pan, the heat will transfer from the colder object to the hotter object. The heat transfer takes place in that way. So that process is called as a conduction. Now the next is convection. Convection is the process in which the molecules are moving. Means the teacher will stand at particular place and call out some numbers, call out the students to, and the students will move from the particular place to the teacher. So that is the process, actually the convection takes place. Means what happens if you are taking a water, if you are boiling the water, then you can see if you are boiling the water, the molecules which are here, when they get heat, as they get heat, the molecules will move upward. Are you getting? They become a lighter and they move upward. And the cold water or the warm water will come down as they are heavier. Then again they will get cool and again they will move. So this process is called as a convection, in which the molecules are actually moving. In this, the molecules are actually moving. In this, we have seen the sea breeze and land breeze. And the last point is of radiation. This is how the transfer of heat takes place. Radiation means what? Here, no medium is required. In radiation, we do not require any kind of medium. Are you getting this? Means, for example, the best example is sun. When the light of the sun directly reaches to the earth, am I right? So that as the light reaches directly to the earth, that is the process of radiation. Means what? When a teacher is standing on the place and students are also on the place, the notebook is directly thrown to the particular child. Means directly that particular child gets the notebook. So that is the process where the radiation takes place. Means the sun is emitting the light and heat and up. And on the earth, when the light reaches to the earth, or the heat we get directly from the sun by the process of radiation. So this is how about the transfer of heat. There is also one more point: conductor and insulator. The material through which the heat can transfer, that is called as a good conductor of heat. For example, metals are the good conductor of the heat. If a bad conductor is what, the material which do not allow the heat to pass through them, that is called as a bad conductor. It is also called as an insulator. Bad conductors is also called as an insulator. For example, plastic, it comes under the bad conductor of heat, that is also called as an insulator. Are you getting this? In this also we have learned one more point of expansion of heat, effect of heat. When the any solid substance is heated, it get expand. Even the liquids, when the heat is applied to the any liquid substance, it get expand. Are you getting? And when it is When it is cooled down, it get contract. For this, we have done the number of activities. For example, expansion of the heat. In the fifth standard, we have done when we have done one experiment of iron and ring ball and iron ball and a ring. Before heating, it was another ball was not going easily, am I right? But when we provide when we heat that ring, it got expanded, am I right? And the ball was passing easily. So that is what expansion of heat of solid. Then expansion of liquid, we have done the activity. And when the this is how the effects, these are the effects of
vacuum flask or thermos flask. Thermos flask is used to keep things warm and cold. It consists of a double walled glass flask having vacuum between the walls, kept inside a metallic case with cork supporters. The outer and inner surfaces of the glass flask are highly silvered. The mouth of the flask is fitted with airtight cork. The vacuum between the two walls of the flask prevents heat transfer by conduction or convection. The silver coating of the walls of the vessel reflects back heat radiations. Thus, heat by radiation can neither enter inside nor go out of the flask. The airtight cork, which is bad conductor of heat, prevents any loss of heat by conduction or convection. Some heat may be transferred by conduction through thin glass walls at the neck and the poorly conducting cork.
The lesson thoroughly and remove the notes. Tomorrow I am going to conduct small test on it. Thank you.